I'm Lisa, the artist behind Lachri Fine Art. Today we are going to be taking a look at two wax-based pencils, Prismacolor Premier and the Luminance pencils by Caran. Starting off with the Prismacolor Premier, these pencils I started using about 20 years ago. Back then, they were actually made very well. The company had built a very good reputation for itself on these pencils. They have a large color range, which are super, super smooth to blend with. These are an easy pencil to find here in the US. Actually, they're pretty much the only colored pencil that you're gonna find in most art stores. They're also one of the most inexpensive of the different colored pencils available for artists, which do make them quite attractive to many buyers. Sounds great, however, several years ago, Prismacolor changed how and where they are making their pencils. And when that change happened, their quality control just kind of went out the window. Prismacolor is a very, very brittle lead, and that isn't something that I judge them negatively for. That's just part of their pencil, and that's fine. And it was fine when their wood casings were good. Their wood casings now are prone to splitting down the edge when you sharpen the pencil. The lead in the pencils are no longer centered. There are a lot of problems with these pencils now. And the reason that all of these things matter is because Prismacolor is such a brittle lead, they need consistent wood casings to help keep that lead from breaking more than it needs to. It's widely known if you drop a Prismacolor pencil, you are likely to break the lead all the way inside the wood casing. Now, because the wood casings themselves are so poorly constructed, just sharpening your pencil can be enough to cause the lead to break inside the casing. What's happening is on these wood casings that are either warped or the lead is off center, you're adding pressure points to that lead inside the casing. So as you're sharpening, they're just splitting all the way down inside. Another problem that we're seeing with these pencils now is where the lead will fall completely out of the wood casing. Prismacolor on their own website claims that when this happens, they will replace the lead. Kind of tells you how often this happens, that they had to put it under their frequently asked questions section in their website. Those who I've personally known who had this happen and did contact them to have the pencil replaced are still waiting months later for that replacement pencil. I don't know about you guys, but when I am working on a project, I can't sit around waiting for replacement pencils on a defective product. If you are using Prismas, there are a few things that you can do to avoid the breakage. First is to use an electric sharpener instead of a handheld sharpener. This will make a huge, huge difference in how often your pencils break. They're still going to break. Your wood casings will still split, just not nearly as bad as they would were you using a handheld sharpener. If you have a pencil and you know that the lead has been broken all the way down inside the wood casing, you can melt that lead back together by holding it under a heat lamp or on a heating pad or letting it sit in the sun. You can do a few things like that. You do have to watch that you don't overdo it, because if you do, all of that lead can melt out of the wood casing, which makes the problem worse than it was to start with. But those are some things you can do to make the pencils usable again if they are broken all the way inside. All of that is way too high maintenance for my taste, but those are options available to you. Prismacolor colored pencils are available both open stock and in full sets up to 150 pencils, which is a lot of colors, but be aware, not all of those colors are lightfast. This means that a lot of those colors are going to fade when they are exposed to light. Prismacolor does follow the ASTM measure for lightfastness, but they do not mark the individual pencils with that information. If you want that information, you need to go to their website, and I will put a link below in the video description, and you can see exactly which colors are lightfast and which ones are going to be prone to fading. Only pencils that are marked as a 1 or a 2 on that lightfast scale can be labeled as complying with the standard according to the Colored Pencil Society of America. Why does this matter? Because in as little as a few months to a few years, that painting that you spent all those hours completing, certain colors can completely change from being bright and bold to faded and dull depending on which colors that you used. Back in February of this year, I completed this flamingo using the Prismacolor colored pencils. While working on this piece, I got so sick of the nonstop breakage. I felt like I was spending more time trying to repair pencils and try to get them sharpened than I was actually working on the piece. It just was not a fun process. After all the frustration that I had working on this piece, I started looking for alternatives. I ended up ordering a set of Polychromos colored pencils, which I do love. The only thing that I really didn't like with those were the white and cream pencils. They were very, very translucent, and I prefer those colors to be more opaque. So to avoid having to continue working with the Prisma whites, I ordered a couple of white Luminance pencils to try out. Now, I'm not gonna lie, I was kinda hoping I wouldn't like them because they are an expensive pencil. I get that, and I kinda had the attitude, there's no way these can be worth that money, but at the same time, I was sick of throwing away money on the Prisma pencils that just kept breaking, so I gave it a shot. I ended up loving those pencils so much that I decided it was time to go ahead and give the entire set a try. These Luminance pencils are not carried in any of the local art stores. In most cases, you're gonna need to go online to order them. Good news is, because they are open stock, you can try out a handful of them and see how much you like them before you invest in the whole set. The largest set of Luminance colored pencils comes in 76. The biggest thing about these pencils is that they are the only ones where the entire set complies with the ASTM D6901, there's a lot of numbers in there, scale of being lightfast. This is important when you want your work to last, especially if you're selling your work. The last thing you want is a customer coming back to you in a few months or in a year wanting to know why that beautiful piece that they bought from you is now faded. The chickadee that I shared with you guys last week was the first piece that I did using all Luminance colored pencils. I found that they layered and blended quite nicely, and overall they felt very, very similar to working with Prismacolors, which I know a lot of you who want wax-based pencils, that's going to be good news for you. Except they don't break. I was not expecting that. I expected them to be more brittle like the Prismas were, and they really aren't. At no point did I have any of these pencils break, no matter how much pressure I applied to them. The other thing is, when you sharpen a Prismacolor colored pencil, you don't want the long, long skinny tip on there, because it is going to definitely break when you get it that sharp. You want to go with it to where it's more angled. With the Luminance pencils, you can sharpen them to a fine, fine point, and they do hold that point very well. So I was really happy to see how much more detail I was able to get with the Luminance pencils than I was with the Prisma. So I had the blendability that I did with the Prismas and the ability to get detail more easily than I was able to with Prismas. That was pretty exciting for me. I don't get out much. There were a few additional differences. One, some of the darker browns, the black, the darkest gray, some of those pencils are a bit scratchy or dry feeling to work with. I've seen where other artists had complained about this. When I first experienced that, I didn't like it, but as I continued to work and to layer, the end result came out just the same as with the pencils that were creamier in the set. So there was no visible difference between the two, but I did end up doing a little bit more layering with them to get the same result. There weren't many of the pencils in the set that had that kind of dry or scratchy feel. Most of them were super, super creamy. The next difference was that they didn't seem to build up as much of a wax bloom as the Prismacolor pencils did. And that allowed me to do more layering. And because they do sharpen to that finer point, the combination of being able to layer more and then being able to hold a fine point, the detail work was so superior to what I was able to get with the Prismas. I wanted to try out both of these pencils side by side on the same project. So I chose this photo that was taken by wildlife artist Jason Morgan because it was going to allow me to test both the blendability as far as that background, because it has so many colors that fade from one to the next very softly, and some of the more detailed work on the butterfly and on the flowers. While I was working on the background, I did notice that I was burning through my Prismacolors faster than I was on the Luminance pencils. It seemed like the Luminance pencils got better coverage, or they went a lot farther. I have no idea why that is. It was just something that I noticed with the Prismacolor. I had to continuously sharpen those where I wasn't needing to with the Luminance, not even taking into account how many times the Prismacolors broke on me. While I easily achieved the same blended look in the background with both pieces, one interesting thing, I found that I used way more colors with the Prismacolor to get the same look that I did with the Luminance. I had to keep layering gray on top of my blues to tone them down with the Prismacolor. The Luminance set, I'm really, really happy with how many natural tones they have. For me, being a portrait artist and doing a lot of wildlife work, I am really, really happy with some of these natural colors that Luminance offers. And I realize it's total personal preference. I was just so happy with the colors available in the Luminance set, which, again, was not expecting because I thought it was going to be a problem having less colors available. And obviously, you can get the colors that you need by mixing and blending. It just was interesting to me that I found more colors I wanted out of the Luminance set versus the Prismas that had more colors available. Once I moved on to the flowers, this is where I noticed the biggest difference with these two pencils. The Prismacolors are just, I don't enjoy trying to get detail work with them. A combination of the amount of wax bloom that they have and the fact that they don't want to stay sharpened real well, that it just makes it difficult to get some of the finer detail. Whereas with the Luminance, that went very, very easy. I ended up spending a lot more time working on the flowers in the Prismacolor side than I did on the Luminance side because I was trying so hard to get that detail and to make them look nice, but it wasn't working for me. And now these pieces were very quickly done. I did each piece in about 4 hours, so this is not some amazing masterpiece. Had I slowed down, I could get more detail. It's just a lot harder to do with the Prisma than it is with the Luminance. Now when I got to the butterfly, it was pretty much the same situation with the detail work. The Luminance Black is one of the scratchier, drier pencils in the set, so if I were filling in one big, huge chunk of black, the Prismacolor is going to fill in more smoothly slightly faster. The Luminance can get the same look, I'm just gonna have to do more layers. However, here in this case where I was trying to get the detail, the Luminance was doing what I wanted. I was able to get the veining and all of the detail where it faded from the black into the gray. The black wings on the Prismacolor side, they're just kind of big globs of black. It's just so hard to get the detail in there. So even if you're looking at these two and thinking, well, I like the way the Prismacolor one came out better because it has higher contrast, that wasn't what I was trying to get in this case. I wanted them both to have the detail that the Luminance side had, where there was more gray and more veining in the wings. In the end, they are very, very similar to work with. Trying to blend those smooth backgrounds, they're both super, super smooth pencils. But when I got into the detail, I definitely preferred the Luminance over the Prismas. Now, I'm not saying that you cannot create stunning, stunning work with Prismacolor. You obviously can. We've all seen artwork out there done by artists who use Prisma, and they're amazing. I've also seen amazing paintings done with sand, so there's that. But the point is, you can create beautiful work with it. I don't mean to imply that you can't. Comparing these two brands, I personally, hands down, will take the Luminance over Prismacolor any day. They had the smoothness of the Prismas, but they were so much easier to get detail with, not to mention being lightfast. Now, the big thing everyone keeps asking me about these pencils is it worth it to spend that much more for the Luminance? The Luminance are quite a bit more expensive than the Prismas. A set of 150 Prismacolor colored pencils is going to run you about $130 through a website like Jerry's Artarama or dickblick.com. They're more if you buy them in store. Whereas a full set of 76 Luminance pencils is going to run you about $315 on the same websites. There are a few factors to consider here when making your choice. First, the reason that Luminance are so much more expensive is they are a high quality product. They are lightfast. The company is so focused on making the most lightfast product, the most high quality product for artists to use. And it really shows when you work with these pencils. When you sharpen them, there's no breakage, they don't split, the wood casings are good. There's just a huge, huge difference in the actual quality of each pencil. When figuring out the cost of each pencil, I looked at each individual pencil when you purchase them open stock. With the Prismas, they're gonna run you $1.03 on Jerry's Artarama or dickblick.com, or anywhere from $2 to $3 when you buy them open stock in a store like Michael's, Hobby Lobby, Aaron Brothers, any of those. The price for those on both Dick Blick and Jerry's states that that's their everyday lowest price, so you can't use any of their coupons to discount that further. For the Luminance on those same websites, they run $3.91 per pencil. But it does appear that you can use their 20% off or 30% off, whatever coupon they send you through their email newsletters on the individual Luminance pencils. While that is a significant difference in cost, I can honestly say I would rather pay more for the Luminance than fight constantly with the Prismacolors. Another thing to consider is that the Prismacolors are actually costing more than they appear because you're constantly having to sharpen them when they do break. Not to mention, it did seem like I was burning through the Prismas faster even when they weren't breaking than I was with the Luminance, so that's something to keep in mind too. I stated before, I feel that Prismacolor is currently a defective product. They've been selling pencils that are warped, pencils where the lead is not properly secured inside the casing, pencils with bad wood casings altogether, for years. These pencils should never have made it past their quality control. Complaints have been sent to this company by artists about this problem for years, but they've not improved. Those of us who were using Prismacolor before they started cutting corners, we know that the company can make good products. They used to. They're just choosing to cheap out and sell us an inferior product. As a consumer, this is insulting. As an artist who depends on my materials to be both archival and dependable, they aren't even remotely an option for me anymore now that I know there are better options out there. If you're new to my channel, I have new video critiques every Tuesday where I'm critiquing your original paintings or drawings, my own speed paintings, drawings, and tutorials every Wednesday, social media tips for artists every Thursday, and artist vlogs each weekend. So I would love for you to subscribe and follow me on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, Tumblr, Google+, all those fun social media sites. Links are below in the video description. You can keep up with news, my newest work, and see real-time clips of whatever it is I'm currently working on. I'll see you guys tomorrow.